So, can drawing be used in a regular business environment? Today, that's what I'm going to be talking about with the review of the book, The Back of the Napkin by Dan Rome. Hi, my name is Luis Escobar. I'm a storyboard artist on The Simpsons television show. I've been working on the show for over 20 years now, and I'm here to empower you. And one of the things that I've read was this book, Back of the Napkin. And I find this book to be one of the most fascinating reads I've had in when it comes to drawing, because what it does is it brings drawing into a place where it becomes one of the most practical ways to use drawing in an environment that you would never consider drawing to be an asset. Which would be, say, like if you're a businessman trying to, do presentations and things like this. And well, it turns out that drawing is incredibly beneficial because of its visual aspects. And this book is really, really thick, explaining how you're able to use drawing in a situation like in a business when you're trying to learn how to be able to get an idea across, express an idea, solve problems using your drawing skills. Well, I mean, it even says right here, solving problems, selling ideas with pictures. And this is exactly what this is about. And we are shown through this system explaining, for example, what goes into a presentation because of the science behind being able to see and perceive how people gather information, how they retain information, how we see, think about concepts and ideas. And this book, what it does is it breaks it down so that you're able to very quickly communicate ideas using visuals that you yourself create in order to be able to sell a presentation, a concept, an innovation, solve problems again using visuals from the start. Just coming up with if there's a problem with the business or how or the structure, you'll be able to just draw it all and put it there visually and be able to yank and pull, push, and then move things around because you have the drawing ability to, you have the skill to make it visual so that you can do such a thing. And you don't have to be a master artist. You could draw something as simple as little stick figures and symbols. But the idea behind this is very simple, which is draw it, put it out there, be clear. In fact, the simpler the better, because that way there's no room for interpretation. You just create these symbols. It's amazing. It's such a really smart book. I can't recommend this enough if you're just if this is something that is you're if you are working in a business, if you think that drawing is only part of a hobby that you can just use it for as a hobby. Well, no, this actually shows you why it's practical to be able to also use this to actually be able to make your job and your business even make money presenting ideas and this and but see, and this all comes back to when just everyday life, just trying to convince somebody of something, or there's an idea that you want to communicate that is simple, just sketch it out and use it. And this explains why it works and why it's good to be able to draw and not to be afraid to do it and to get good at it. And it's just amazing. I think this is such a good read just because by the very fact that it makes drawing practical, something that people assume is only an entertainment product or a hobby, you would have never thought that it would be this practical. So highly recommend reading The Back of the Napkin by Dan Rome. I will have a link to this book in the description of this video. So if you're interested, scroll down and check it out. Thanks. And if you've hit a wall when it comes to drawing, if you want to draw what you want to draw rather than what just comes out of you, if you want to get better faster, if you want to start drawing more consistently, if you want your proportions to work, if you want your drawings to be more solid, go over to my Patreon. I give my time to giving you personal training, personal coaching, depending on the tier that you're in. So if you've really want to improve, then I highly recommend you take my coaching tier, where we get together, we find out what it is that your goals are, and then I cater a group of lessons and assignments specifically for your needs, and then you send them over back to me once you're done with the assignments, and then I critique them and help you improve and work with you so that you can get over the hump, get over the things that are frustrating you. So if you've hit that wall and you really, really, really want to improve and you want to do it fast, because really the truth is that you can improve without any coaching at all whatsoever. However, if you want to improve faster, because the best way to get good is to be told exactly what you need to work on from somebody who has been there and gone through it, then I'm here for you. There are positions limited. There's already positions taken up. There's only 5 positions. But once they're filled, then you're going to have to wait. So highly recommend, if you're really into this position, then move fast and get in on it right away. Go to my Patreon. The link is here on the screen. But if you want to, you just press the link on the subscription of this video. Description of this video, and you will get sent to that specific tier to my Patreon, so that you can sign up for that personal coaching if you want. And if you're not into necessarily personal coaching, there's other rewards, giveaways, wallpapers, and all kinds of other things that you can take a look at and maybe subscribe to. Plus, you're supporting these videos that I use to answer your questions for free. So thank you for your support, but I just wanted to make you aware of this other thing that I do, so that in case it sounds like something you'd like, you can go ahead and do it. All right, so thanks a lot for everything, and I'll see you next time. All right, bye.